guys. Welcome once again to One Coin Only. The journey continues in getting my voice back, and I feel like my voice is a little bit better than what it was yesterday. So we're just getting that tiny bit closer. I'm pretty excited. And speaking of excited, I'm excited to have you guys. Thank you for coming, and we're going to be playing this off the original hardware today. As you can see, we got Resident Evil 1. And we're going to be playing this with the Hyperkin widescreen cable today, guys. And you can see basically what it looks like in widescreen. We're going to try and play through the whole thing. And yeah, big thank you for coming in. We are live on both Facebook and YouTube. And on YouTube, we got Ty there. Good to see you. And oh, thank you, Ty. I appreciate that. We got Matthew. Good to see you. And we got Mikey. We got Captain BS over on the Facebook. We got Nick, Benjamin, Daniel, Nate. We got Philip, Sandra, Mark. We got Mr. D. Wayne himself, Mr. Headlock Gaming. We got Benny. We got Adam. We got Susan. We got Chris. We got Daniel with the big 500 stars, as well as Nick with 100 stars. Thank you so much, guys. I'm going to be right with you. We got Branch. We got Philip. We got Mike, Angel, Seth, Ben, Bong. Thank you very much. All right, Nick. Nick and Daniel, this one is going out to you today. Thank you very much, everybody. We got like 9 new thank you screens tonight.
She was a bad egg.
There we go. Thank you so much for the star love, guys. Appreciate ya. And there we go. A little bit of Willy Wonka segueing into Metallica. That's a bit different, isn't it? And how you going, Raymond? Perrin, Philip, Rooster, good to see you. Again, don't forget, copy and paste is your friend. It's a little bit hard to read all the comments out at the beginning, so help a brother out. All right, well, we may as well get started, hey? And I'll load up for the beginning. There'll be, like, the cutscene at the beginning and stuff, which will really help us out as everyone starts coming in. How you going, Jamie? Yeah, today is the day, my friend. Today is the day. We got this on lock, bro. Let me know how the volume is before we get too far in, too, hey? All right, well, let's get started. I am today, Jeremy. Good to see you. We got Mel. Good to see you, Mel. Thank you very much. Of course you did, Branch. We appreciate you coming in. We're going to play as Jill today. Now, it's been a while since I've played this using ink ribbons as a game intended. I'm usually a safe state guy, so I don't want to make it too difficult to me for the first time round. Director's cut's pretty good too, Nightmare, but yeah, we're doing the OG one today. How you going? Alpha team is I'm picking Jill today, Nate. Situated in Northwest. Oh, here we go, we're going to play out the little cutscene. Don't forget to like and share if you can, guys. It helps us out if you don't mind. Let me just make sure I've got the right game tag. Making sure I've got the right, you know, I do have the right game tag.
In Raccoon City.
That works.
There are outlandish reports of families being attacked by a group of about 10 people.
And,
victims were apparently eaten.
Alright.
Bravo team went to the hideout of the group and disappeared.
Mel says, of course you're here. Where else would you be? Oh, I guess you bring up a good point. Where, you know, One Coin's a place to be, right? And, Joseph, it's going alright. I've only been up for about an hour, sir. I had a long sleep last night, and I could have kept going, seriously. Like, I probably had almost 8 hours sleep for the first time in, like, 3 weeks last night, and I still needed an alarm clock to wake up.
Nobody was in it.
It's crazy.
But strangely, most of the equipment was still there.
And, how you going, Rob? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. And so Angel says, do I prefer Ricky or One Coin? You know what, Angel? I don't mind either. You can call me whatever you like, my friend. And how you going, Alan? Good to see you. We got Susan. Yeah, I mean, it's been a while since I got that Shawnee. That's probably why I wanted to keep going. Yeah, I don't feel too bad. I'm still waking up a little bit, though. Anyone seen that Slack of Barry? We'll deal with that shortly. Mel, you flatter me too much. Jim says sleep is... It is. And Mikey thinks I look a lot more well-rested. Yeah, I need to get rid of these big black eyes under my freaking head, though. Maybe One Coin needs to start moisturizing. Get that supple skin. It's actually lunchtime, Alan. It's 12 o'clock. 12 p.m. Yeah, I know what you're talking about, Nick. That's actually a pretty good deal, huh? How you going, Amanda? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Aaron says walking by the windows and this always gave you anxiety. Yeah, man, the jump scares were real with the dogs back in the early days, huh? I'm desensitized to it now, Aaron, but back then it was a pretty big deal. And Mo has just dropped a big 100 stars too. Thank you so much, Mo. What are we going to give to Mo? We're going to give you this one, Mo.
Jill Valentine.
Thank you so much, Mo. Mo with a big 100 stars. How you doing today, Mo? Hey, going, LaTroy. Good to see you. Yeah, it's noon on a Tuesday in Aussie right now. Apparently, Rebecca Chambers did not get credited. And there was a gamer that actually found her like 20 years later in real life and interviewed her about the bit part. Or something like that. Apparently, they had a lot of fun doing it, but yeah, they did. I don't think they got credited. At least a couple of them didn't. How you going, Veronica? Veronica, I'm okay. I'm more worried about you, my friend. I'm fine.
Captain Wesker, where's Chris?
Jeez, I tell you what, for something that's supposed to put it in HD, it's still pixelated. Oh, well, it is what it is.
What is it?
How you going, Chris? Thank you so much for hanging out.
Now, Jill, can you go?
I'm going with you. Chris is our old partner.
Yeah, as I said, we're playing off the original disc.
Let me
hang. Oh, my gosh, Marcus, what are you doing, my friend? I have never, ever gotten the... Oh, my God. Give me 1 second, guys. Let's have to pause the game in a second. We just got dropped really hard on YouTube. Why are you worried about me for, Veronica? Veronica, it's just really, really hard to do so many things at once, and there's a lot of people in here that don't have the patience with me. Apart from that, I'm super. People, you don't realize how much is going on this side of the screen. Marcus, dude. All right, I have to pull... Oh, my gosh. All right. Oh, boy. Marcus has dropped, like, a massive... $100 super chat over on YouTube. Dude, I don't even know what to say. That is absolutely incredible, sir. Oh boy, Marcus, thank you so much, dude. I actually made a special thank you screen for Marcus, so we're gonna use that right now, as well as a couple of... First of all, this one. Oh my gosh, and one more. And, dude, thank you. Man, I don't even know what to say, Marcus. Thank you so much. That wasn't necessary, my man, but I really, really appreciate you. That is... Bro, that's too much. That really is too much, dude. Oh my gosh. I'm in the full screen.
What?
I like this at full screen. I don't like that it's all pixelated, though. But we'll get to it. Marcus says he's going to love the dance. That's the least I can do for you, sir. Oh, my goodness.
I'll be examining this.
So Angel says if I had dinner, I actually had some pizza for breakfast. I know, healthy, right? I ordered some pizza last night because I hadn't had my cheat meal for the week yet. And, thank you, Alan. Yeah. You liking the Lombardo remix? Well, Marcus was the one that gave that to me. Marcus found it, and then I chopped up the video and remixed it. Kid Jackson says the voice acting, and this is cutting. Well, it really is, isn't it? I mean, totally. And we're going to go back over here. All right. So we have to use ink ribbons today, so I'm a little bit nervous. Is he dead yet? No, he's not. We're going to wait for him to get back up. Oh, now he should be dead. Yeah, fantastic. We can get, like... Can't we get, like, 2 bullet clips from here or something? Now he's become a mere shadow of his former self. Poor Kenneth, huh? And so Catherine says, you love my art. It's very bold, isn't it? Definitely got a very bold shirt on today. Technically widescreen. I know what you mean, yeah. I mean, everything's in proportion at least. Philip says this looks way different from the remake. Yeah, we're going back. We're going back to the past, mate. We're going back to the past today. Yeah, Marcus is totally balling out. Balling out with awesome screens and the coin. Alright, I guess we'll go talk to Barry Nuts over here. I need some more water. This pizza's giving me the hiccups right now.
What is it?
James, thank you so much for the 100 stars. I'm going to be right with you as well, James. Appreciate you. So how's everyone's day going? What's everyone been up to? Any big news today? Anything that I don't know yet? And, yeah, you know my taste, Marcus. Any more screens like that, send them my way. I got you.
Anyway, let's report this to Wesker.
And, So David says this game started so many great games. It really did, didn't it? And what was I going to do? Sorry, James has got 100 stars too. All right, we're going to do another thank you screen for James. Here you go. Thank you, James. As I said, we got 9 new thank you screens. And because you sumbitches are all so generous, they're going to be used in 5 seconds. How you going, Payron? Good to see you. I've heard of it, Nate. I know the game. I never tried it myself personally. I've been curious about it.
Help me look for him, Jill.
Oh, Veronica says she took Bugs to the pet store so she could pick her toy out. And says, oh, that's cute. But you sort of just grab whatever she gravitates to, huh? That's nice. All right. Oh, Viper's playing Resident Evil 2 Remake now. Uh-huh. We're gonna go back down here. Alright, get out of there. Susan says my voice is sounding a lot better. I've almost got it back. It's about at 70-80% now. I don't feel, at least today, I really have to strain to talk. Yesterday was really hard because I had to strain to talk, but today I feel like I'm okay. So we're getting there. We're getting a Contra board game next year. A Contra board game?
Let's search for him separately. I'll check the dining room again.
That's interesting, isn't it?
Okay. I'll try the door on the opposite side.
And
this mansion is gigantic.
So Jay says you had your second to last appointment today, been in and out of the doctor's office. And hospital, so fingers crossed you won't need to go back. I hope not too.
Jill.
Hope everything will be okay, my friend.
It might be handy if you, the master of unlocking, take it with you.
Here you go, Jill, you're the master of unlocking.
Thanks. Maybe I'll need it.
Okay, just make sure you don't become a Jill sandwich. And, Travis says, what's up, Rick Dog? How you doing today, buddy? Thank you, Travis. I'm doing good. I'm curious to know how a Contra board game would work. And, yes, I know the game, Michael. Oh, gosh. I wonder if there's an ink ribbon here. There is, isn't there? We need to get a couple of these. Will you take the ink ribbon? We won't need too many of these. Alright, there's going to be another one over here, I think. Can we go this way yet? And, alright, let's keep going. And how you going, Alex? Good to see you. I'm doing good, man. I'm just trying to warm up here. We're gonna be careful, because I think we're gonna get a zombie here for our troubles. Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna worry about that ink ribbon. I don't think that one's as important. I can't even talk right now, guys. Oh my goodness, lucky I've got this bottle of Pepsi next to me so I can have more caffeine. Let's go in this room. Tracy, thank you. Tracy says she's sending me some scary stars my way. Handsome. Well, there you go. I don't get called handsome every day. Thank you, Tracy. What can we give to Tracy? You know what? We're going to give you this because it's ladies' night, my friend. This is for you, Trace. Thank you so much, Trace. Trace with a big 100. And, guys, I can't read out every single comment just because a lot of them are really, really long. So forgive me. And, oh gosh, here we go. Give me one second here. So Jeremy says, you love me, Ricky. Thank you, Jeremy. Right back at you, bro. I hope you're having a great day. I hope your health is all right, my friend. And, let's keep going. I think we're going to get a free clip of ammo in this little box, if I'm not mistaken. So, yes, when I was 16 years old, I used to get caught up in that jump scare here. Is there stars not showing up, or is there something wrong with your screen? No, Commodore messaged me before I started, and apparently sometimes stars are not coming up today. There's a bug with Facebook. The good news is they're going through, but if you send stars and I miss them, please let me know with a star amount so I can say thank you. It's a Facebook glitch today. I don't know how many stars you sent, Mikey, but let me know so I can give you a great big thank you. But no, it's a Facebook glitch today. Mel, thank you. Just a little bit of a star. Thank you, Mel. I really appreciate that. Mel, this is going out to you. Mel, thank you very, very, very much for the 100 stars. Going from Metallica to Mariah Carey. Rick's got everything here. Oh, gosh. Yeah, good on you, Jeremy. Keep on keeping on, hey? Can we go on this one yet? And you were looking for Marcus's stars from before. Oh, no, Marcus sent a super chat, not stars. Marcus sent a super chat. It's different. Hang on, what's in here? Let's have a look at what's in here. And Ryan just dropped 100 stars. Thank you so much, Ryan. I'm going to be right with you. And yeah, guys, absolutely. That's the best way you can help is by liking and sharing the stream, right? And I don't think there's anything in here. There you go. Maybe she can drop a deuce. Although I don't really want to watch Jill drop a deuce. Ryan, thank you again for an awesome 100 stars. This is for you. Here you go, brother. Marcus says, yes, Ricky, need it. I still can't believe you did that, Marcus. That's a little bit too much excitement for me first thing in the morning. Thank you again. Ryan, thank you so much for the 100 stars, dude. I am, all right, so we're going to go Jill sandwich ourselves, I think, just around this corner. And, all right, so far so good. Then we can save for the first time. And, oh, boy. Just doing what you can while you're... Hey, you know what? I like that we're playing the actual version, so this room doesn't, like, glitch out today. How you going there, Chris? Good to see you. Going old school today. Yeah, man, we're doing this in widescreen, Nick. I'm pretty excited to have this in widescreen today. Playing off the Hypercon widescreen HDMI cable for PS1 and PS2. PS2 games on that cable look mint. The PS1 games... Not bad, but you can see they're still a little bit pixelated, you know. And Philip says, love you, mate. Always a great time on your stream. Philip, thank you for the 100 stars, dude. You didn't need to do that. Chris, I just usually rather than do one star screen for like a big star drop, I'll usually just do a big celebration of 4 or 5 star screens and make a big fuss, you know what I mean? But, yeah, you know, I might. It's not a bad idea to come up with something for the dragon. We need Barry to come and help us, so give me a sec. And I won't be 1 second, Philip and Andy. Thank you so much. Jill? That wouldn't be a bad idea for a scream as well. What happened?
Barry, help me, please.
There you go. Tracy said you streamed some Mortal Kombat 11 with your nephews. I like Mortal Kombat 11, especially with all the features it's got, but I prefer to play number 10. Hurry, this way. And I'm going to leave number 11 to D-Wayne, I think. Leave this shit to the experts, eh?
Oh, Barry!
That was you, Barry. Close. Oh, you.
You were almost a sandwich.
But Barry.
Grow up, Rick. How old are you? 5? Grow up, Rick. Alright. Andy says, good evening, Mr. Rick. Good evening to you too, Andy. Thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you, Barry.
And, all right, there we go. So that's all sorted. Now I need to quickly go back and get this bazooka. So let me just go back through the star donations. We got 150 from Andy, 150 from Philip, and Ricky's become possessed. Yeah, I'm a freaking nutcase, mate. What could I tell you? This is going out to you guys. What else haven't I done? I've actually done all of them now already. Can you believe? Oh, no, here we go. There you go, we'll do this one again. Oh gosh, you guys are awesome. Thank you so much again for the star love, guys. All right, well, I actually need to quickly backtrack, guys, because I want to just go get this bazooka while we're somewhat close to the vicinity. And we can sort of like put that away at the same time. Since we actually sort of have to use ink ribbons this run, I kind of need to worry about my inventory management a little bit more. And Chris says, slight audio delay. Anyone else having an audio delay? Usually if you back out and come back in, everything syncs back up. Anyone else having an audio delay? Yeah, so I'm just going to quickly go back up and get this bazooka. Don't mind me. And so, oh, here we go. Phillips has been great so far, mate. Just got the car fixed up now. So hopefully stays running. Yeah, fingers crossed, man. Cars are such a pain in the ass. That's the main reason I don't own one right now, because I work from home and I can't be bothered with the maintenance. Yeah, back out and come back in, Chris. So Jeremy says, nah, the delay's only in my brain. Yeah, well, fair call. All right, there we go. So we're just going to quickly go in here and get this bazooka. Let me just double check the inventory. Yeah, we got room. And just want to put everything away at the same time, you know. Then it's done. I think there's going to be some shotgun rounds here too. No, there's not. I'm thinking of Resident Evil 2, perhaps. And it could be tiring, expensive. I know. It's going to be a long time before I can afford it. But I think the next time I buy a car, I'm just going to buy one outright, even if it's just a nice second-hand one. Then I don't have to worry about stupid-ass repayments. It's going to be a long time before I can afford it, but, oh, jeez, I remember when I was young. I mean, I was younger and earning less money, but, gosh, man, I remember how much my quality of life changed when I was a kid and paying back a car. That was not fun. Kid Jackson, you'll be ashamed of myself. I had pizza for breakfast. I had pizza left over. I had a cheap meal last night, and so I continued on. I know, terrible, right? And, Mel says, just a little more. Mel, thank you again for the big 100. I'm going to be right with you, Mel. So we're just going to put these all away in the chest, and we should be good to go. Damn, I tell you what, these older Resident Evil games are much more slow-paced, huh? Alright, Mel, this is going out to you, girl. Thank you so much. The mega, yeah, the mega, yeah, the mega power, yeah. Mega power, yeah. Ooh, yeah, dig it. Thank you so much, sweetheart. I really appreciate you. And, Kit Jackson says you didn't eat breakfast, you went straight to dinner. Well, you could say pizza's technically a dinner item too, couldn't you? Yeah, no, I know what you mean, Phil. Like, you know, they put you on like a 4 or 5 year plan and you're like, ah, fuck. Oh, gosh. You know, by the time I got through, I paid off my first car. I paid up for 5 years, and by the time I finally paid it off, it was a piece of shit. But it was a bit of an older car, though. What was it? Anyway, moving on. I don't know which way to go. That's right, we're gonna go out this way. Sorry, guys, just had a brain fart. Just trying to catch my bearings here, guys. What else is happening? Don't worry, you'll probably get plenty of rage later on when the hunters come and get me. I know a lot of people come in here just to watch me rage. Don't worry, plenty of that's still gonna happen. You know, we've got people in here, they can't just come in to like watch One Coin Only play nice. They have to see me have a temper tantrum or they leave. Cause you know, there's people that pretend to be my friends, but then they only watch when I rage. Wow, Rick's getting deep right now, isn't he? Oh, get off me. Rick's getting way too deep. Oh gosh. Oh gosh, we got this. So Shawnee says he gets out of work in an hour and a half, thank God. Man, I'm glad you get out of work in an hour and a half too. Screw that shit. Nate says, what would you say the main car company in Australia was? Well, it was Holden and Ford, but they no longer make Holdens and Fords in our country anymore, so we're not really known for car companies, unfortunately, now. Yeah, we're not really known for car companies anymore. Here we go. Just need to do this puzzle quickly. Kid Jackson says he's only here for the Twinkies. Well, there you go. I knew it, bro. I knew it. Okay. There's a switch below. Will you push it? Yes. All right, we'll get this. These puzzles are always annoying. I could never figure out what the hell I was doing as a kid. This was too cryptic for me. I think I overthink puzzles sometimes. It's probably why I'm so bad at them. Probably because I'm trying to think too hard. Oh, we're going to push that switch. There we go. And we got the old man around the corner. And isn't Subaru... No, Subaru's Japanese, mate. Hang on one second. Alright, no, we're going to go no. Jeremy says, are you One Coin Only on Steam? My Steam account is pinned in the face. I'll give it to you afterwards, Jeremy. Kid Jackson says he's only here for the Twinkies. I wish I had free Twinkies to give out. Seriously, you know, I give away the cash prizes for supporter every month, and our supporters are probably like, screw you, Rick, we're here for the Twinkies. Well, you guys, don't you realize with a cash prize you can buy 10 boxes of Twinkies? I'm just saying. Yeah, Subaru's Japanese, my friend. I think they do have like a special, I think they have like an Outback model of the Subaru. But that's like a deal with a car company in Australia, you know what I mean? I don't know much about cars, so I could be way off. Alright, so we're going to go in here. Alright, we can finally go into a chest and save. Your mail says you were told there were cookies. No cookies. You don't like Twinkies? I remember back when I first streamed, ADD Gamer and I swapped food packages. And ADD Gamer sent me some Twinkies. He actually sent me two boxes of Twinkies and they were gone within like 24 hours. You can't carry any more items. Of course I can't. Alright, well, we're gonna go in here for now. Thank you, David. We're hanging in there, hey? And, as I said, thank you so much for your patience, guys. It gets a little bit tricky reading comments sometimes. How you going, Ken? Good to see you. And, alright, we're gonna put that away. That away. That away, man, see, it's gonna make, oh no, we don't need to put that away yet, because we gotta save first. And then we got to bring out these, I hated how in the first Resident Evil we had to combine these. Like in the sequel, they combine automatically, but you know, it is what it is. Alright, so let's quickly save the game. You can save your progress with this. Okay, will you push the ink ribbon? Yes. So we have to do this the old-fashioned way because we don't have save states. We're playing off the hardware. Derek says Ricky's a real-life Superman. I don't know about that. So no need to apologize, Phil. Yeah, but I get given a hard time about it all the time. You know what I mean? I feel like I constantly have to remind people because people don't give it a rest. And Nightmare says if the Resident Evil mansion was real, minus all the monsters and traps, you'd love to live in it. Nah, man, this place looks too creepy for me. It's definitely not for me. Alright, let's go. Let's bounce. Ryan just dropped another 100 stars. Thank you, Ryan. This is for you. And Sir Dash sends his regards. Big shout out to Sir Dash Gaming. Thank you, Ryan. I really, really appreciate you, man. And good to see you today, too, Steve. Thank you for popping in. I don't know which way to go first. Having a little bit of a brain fart here. Actually, this is not the right way. I don't think. All right, we'll just go down in here. I think, is he dead now? All right, let's just get out. You unlocked it. All right, let's go. I love that you guys are playing with the stickers too. And so Ryan says, my shoes cost more than your house. Man, I tell you what, I mean, that's sometimes true in some cases. And, you know, there was a girl I dated about 10 years ago, maybe a little bit longer than that now, who had an addiction to Jimmy Choo shoes. And I'm just like, how can you spend like $1,000 on shoes? Are you fucking serious? That's, I don't know how ladies spend $1,000 on shoes and like $5,000 in a freaking handbag. I don't know what purpose it shows apart from like showing off to your friends. I don't, damn man. Anyway. Okay, so we're just going to shoot this sumbitch too. We've got plenty of handgun ammo. We're not in really, is he dead? This handgun's a piece of crap. Oh, there we go. I think he's dead now. All right, cool. Let's keep looking around. And, so Alex says he's a shoehead. He's got... See, I've got guy friends like that too. Like, I've got a friend that needs to get the latest Jordans, the latest Nikes. I'm just like, man, that's... I don't get it. I mean, I get it if you're flipping them. But hey, man, people like what they like, hey? Who am I to say otherwise? Jeremy says his coats are usually $500 coats. Well, la-di-da, Jeremy. There you go, Player 40. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in.
Jill, what's going on? Any clues?
No, but something's wrong with this house.
Whoa. This hall is dangerous. Maybe it's better to secure our escape route first.
Alex says he's pretty much done with the Jordans. The shoe game has been leaked for now. My friends, I've got friends that have like used to like flip shoes for a living. Okay. And they told me it's not as easy as it used to be. Because you've got a lot of like high volume retailers out now setting up bops for auction houses and stuff.
It's really powerful. Especially against living things. Better take it with you.
Big thank you once again for coming in, guys.
I have this.
Thank you. I'll take this then.
You take it, Jill. You take it. Oh, we got some acid rounds. Fantastic. Could you imagine how frustrating this would be if we were playing as Chris with only 6 inventory slots? That's not my idea of a good time. Good to see you, Ivan. Thank you for coming in today. Big shout out to our friends on Puerto Rico. The shining star of the Caribbean. That was a little bit of a WWE line, if you remember that gimmick. And hey man, you know, it's all about ratios. There's some rich people out there that can afford the shoes. That's fine. I remember someone was complaining that Jay-Z spent like $100,000 at a nightclub one night, and that's, but he's worth like something like $500 or $600 million, right? So like $100,000 for Jay-Z is like $100 for the rest of us. It's all about ratios. Right, he's dead too. Fantastic. All right, we got this. Oh gosh. Gotta make sure I don't use too much of this handgun ammo, hey? I tell you what, playing off this off the console, it's hard to explain, but it feels like such a different experience. Oh, we got this there. And you probably buy one or two pairs of boots once a year. I just buy nice looking shoes, man. Like, I probably spend about $50 on my shoes. And they look nice. Whatever. Alright, let's keep going. What have we got now? Man, we're slowly running out of ammo here. This is becoming a problem. It's alright, we've got to clear out these halls. I'd usually take a chance if we were playing with save states, and I'd just try and run past them. But because there's a lot more on the line when you're actually playing off the hardware, I kind of have to be a bit more precautious. A bit more cautious, whatever. Alright, come on, you sumbish. That's vandalism. What'd she do? She didn't vandalize anything, did she? I must be missing something. So Philip says he's had the same shoes for many years now. Hey, man. I mean, don't get me wrong. Sometimes I like to go out and look nice. I don't think I need to spend $5,000 to look nice, though. Help. Sure, it'd help. Thank you, Ryan. You want some mega powers? No worries, Ryan. Thank you so much for the support today. This is going out to you, my man. Thank you so much, Ryan.
Now, with the mega powers.
And, okay, well, which way are we going to go first? Okay. So Mike says you only spend 50 or less and you look in the clearance section. There you go. Alright, so I think we've got another ink ribbon here. We take the ink ribbon. Yes, we're going to stockpile these for later. We're not going to save just yet. I think we're going to be fine for the minute. Alright. Put that away. We're going to have to come back in here in a sec because we're going to have to combine some herbs. Which will be no problem. And thank you again, Ryan, for the stars. As I said, they're appreciated, not expected. Alright, is this a door on... I think I need the armor key for this door on the way back in. It's locked. A carving of armor. Yes, well, we're about to get that key anyway. So Mike says you treat them and put tape on the inside. It's one of those little tricks, eh? Is he dead yet? Yes. Basically, the way you can tell if they're dead is if they have that big blood puddle come. Alright, cool. So let's see what's in this room. Oh, gosh, this is going to be a long game, hey? I feel like we're doing pretty well, all things considered, at the moment. And hey, going Big J Laws, good to see you. How am I doing? Jay, I'm doing great. Really can't complain, man. Everything's all right at the moment. Hey, going Joanne, good to see you. Why does she have a hat in one game and not in the other? I don't know. You're asking me all the hard questions. You're asking me all the hard questions, Joseph. Maybe she didn't feel like wearing a hat. That's all I can think of. But I don't think there's a deeper, darker meaning to it. Alright, so we're just going to make up two herbs here and... Alright, here we go. We're going to make some drugs. Drugs are bad, Mr. Mackim, okay? No, it's okay, Joe. And Joanne says you like the shirt I'm wearing. Thank you. It's actually one of my older shirts, Joanne, but I like the shirt. I kind of like these bolder color shirts. You know, the ones that are like, hey, look at me. Did I hear that PS5 games are going to be $70? I did hear that PS5 games are going to be $70. And, you know, to be honest, guys, I'm not complaining about that because video games have been the same price for years. They were going to have to go up with inflation sooner or later, you know what I mean? So we can't really be too angry about that. I don't think a small price rise is that unreasonable because these games are very expensive to make. So, in saying that, though, I'd rather him charge a higher fee and less for DLC, but because they are getting a bit greedy in that department. And people will pay him. I don't think it's unreasonable to give us... As I said, considering games have like been the same price for the 3 decades, I don't think it's unreasonable to price hike, honestly, to be honest. Hey, I'm a businessman. I get it. Yeah, exactly, Nick. That's what I mean. Back in 1986, it cost my dad $79.99 for Dark Castle and the Apple Mac. You know, it's like... we've had a pretty good run. I have to come back this way, guys. Just give me a wee second, eh? Check this room out quickly. I mean, it depends on the game. That's just me. I don't have a problem. Thank you, Seth. Seth says more free stars, passing them along to our awesome host. Thank you very, very, very much, Seth. And Seth, we're going to rock out again, my friend. This is for you. Thank you so much, Seth. Seth with a 25. I hope Facebook doesn't flag me for Metallica, even though I'm not breaking any rules. I'm getting paranoid because of the whole Lars Ulrich and Napster fiasco, you know what I mean? You know, Lars might try and get me thrown off Facebook. Jacob, and excuse me, that wasn't Jacob, sorry, that was Ryan. Ryan says he'd like to see the hot dog. All right, Ryan, here you go. Oh, gosh, all right. I'm a hot dog. I'm a hot dog. Look at me. Look at me. I can't sing the hot dog song right now. I've got no fucking voice. Ryan, thank you so much again for the 500 stars. I appreciate that. We're going to go back to the right screen now. There we go. Thank you, Ryan. We're going to put this stuff away, then come back out whence we came. And, oh gosh, taking a deep breath. And Oliver says, work, 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 no rest. Well, you mean you or me? Because it's probably accurate on both accounts. Oliver, thank you so much for the 100 stars again, homie. This is going out to you. Thank you, Oliver. Much appreciated, man. Thank you for dropping the big 100 today. And, yeah, I can't sing today, guys. It's like, I'm still trying to get my voice back. I'm going to put all these away for now. I'm not going to take the herbs out till I absolutely need them. Okay, because we got some stuffs to do. All right, let's go back out this way. How you going, L.A. Evans? Thank you for coming in. We're almost out of here. So yeah, we got. Oh shit. We're gonna go back the way we came. I gotta be really careful, because as I said, we haven't saved yet. Not for a while. Trying to be sparing with the ink ribbons, you know? Ricky's voice is gone because of Leroy Jenkins and yelling at trolls. Yeah. It's probably a big part of it. Is he dead yet? Oh, geez, I only took two shots. That was fortunate. You have used the lockpick. All right, let's go in this door. You're waiting for Peyron to drop the Leroy Jenkins star screens. So Ryan says you feel bad about that now. I might just need to disappear for a couple days, because I feel like my voice is now starting to affect my ability to host a show. No, this is not a speed run, Kevin. No. No, it's not. We're going to go in here. Oh, we've got to read the Itchy Tasty book. Derek says, have I come up with any new game ideas? What is what I'm doing now not good enough, Derek? Gosh, man, I tell you what, the Sunbish armies are hard army to freaking please, seriously. Alright, we're gonna go get these shells. So Jordan thinks I sound pretty normal. I'm struggling to talk today, Jordan. Like, I still can't project my voice as well as normal. And, oh, okay, so no, you mean when I make my own? Well, bro, I'm not doing that till next year anyway, and I haven't had any time to think about it yet. I'll think about it when I have time to think about it. I would love to. I've got an idea. I do have one idea, though. I don't know how possible it is, but I do have one very good idea. And Peyron says, Leroy Jenkins, gonna give the people what they want. Seriously, Peyron, you're a fucking asshole, mate. You know I don't have any voice right now. Alright, here we go. Leroy! I can't do it, man. Fuck. Alright, Peyron, thank you for the 100 stars. This is for you.
Leroy! Oh my god, he just ran in.
Thank you, Peyron. That's what we call a troll 100 stars. That's a troll 100 stars. And, alright, here we go. We take the emblem, yes. Wait, we're gonna need some health soon, guys. I didn't realize I was in caution. Hopefully we can find a herb in a sec. Alright, so we're gonna go back and play the piano quickly. And, how you going, Johnny? Good to see you. Thank you again for hanging out. Alright, we're gonna go up here. You have used the lockpick. Don't mind if I do. How you going there, Jake? Good to see you today. Thank you for coming in. Jeremy says I should eat the emblem. You think so? Have a funny feeling it ain't going to taste all that nice, brother. And, you know, just a thought. There we go. The Moonlight Sonata. Let's go play piano. And, so, yeah, it was a Troll 100. So everyone on YouTube's talking about how much they like SNK fighters. I'm gonna disappoint you all and say I think they're way too hard. I do like SNK fighters, but they break my balls. I'd much rather play Street Fighter or Mortal Kombat any day of the week. I appreciate you coming in, Todd. Thank you so much for hanging out today, man. How you going, Shannon? Good to have you. Yeah, itchy tasty. I tell you what, if it's itchy tasty, you should probably go get that checked out at a doctor. And, there you go. So, yeah, man, she's not only sexy and badass, man, but she's got talents, too. Oh, there we go. Will you take the gold emblem? Yes, we will. And, you think I need an impromptu day off just to watch movies? Oh, I don't know, man. I do need to recover a little bit. I just, I don't know. I've got multiple thoughts on the matter, actually, Mike. And, so here we go. Nate says, who's my favorite Street Fighter character to play with? Yours is Sagat. I like to play as, I mean, Ken or Ryu. But in the new ones, I really, really like using Blanka. I like using Rashid. And, yeah, had fun with Charlie Nash the other night, too, actually. Charlie Nash was a pretty good time. And, so Mel says it's quiet, too quiet. You think so? That you think that means a zombie's gonna jump out of the wall at us in a sec or something? Alright, here we go. So let's grab this key. That's two keys now. We're actually doing this pretty quickly, guys. It's not too bad. Will you take the mansion key? So I think that's the sword key. Well, let's start using that key everywhere, hey? Yeah, take a day off and watch Blood In, Blood Out, bro. You can't go wrong. I just feel like it's a catch-22. Like, oh, man, I don't want to sook about it. It's just hard. I feel like there's negatives to, like, if I take time off, and there's negatives to if I don't take time off. Because obviously if you don't take a break, you're not going to have the same energy and people are going to get bored. But if you take time off, people are going to bitch and complain that you took time off. So it's like, I don't know what to do. It's a hard one. Alright, so is he going to... Come on, mate. That should be it. I'm going to get these... Oh, really? After all that? After all that, he still wasn't dead. Are you kidding? Oh, we're in danger. Shit. Okay, that's okay. We're going to get some herbs from the next room. We got to be really, really careful here, guys. We're almost screwed. Distance makes the heart fonder. I think people, like, don't make the effort to watch One Coin Only streams as much as they used to because they're like, oh, well, Rick's just going to be on every day anyway. We'll go watch another stream and we can see Rick whenever we want. So sometimes I think I do need to disappear, actually. Chris, thank you. Chris with a big 100 stars. And so Steve says, maybe a good idea to... You can't host the show with no voice, but true people gonna bitch... Like, Karen's a bitch when we make... Yeah, that like that. And, thank you, Chris. I'm going to be one sec. Chris, this is going out to you, my friend. Thank you. Conrad says he loves seeing me rage, laugh, and just being online. That's a thing. There's not really been any raging yet today. I've just been relaxed. I've just been chill-banging, hey? And Peyron says, if you disappear, you'll find me and bring me back. Conrad says, do what's best for you. Everyone just brings that up like it's so easy. like it's so easy to just, like, be selfish. All right, anyway. It's my problem anyway. We're going to get out of here. All right, we got full health back. I'm feeling a bit more secure now. Thank you again for the 100 stars, Chris. Alfonso says, this and Headlock are the only ones you watch. That means the world. You know, there's a lot of awesome streamers out there, and the fact that you pick us too. And Ryan says, here's to you, Ricky. Ryan dropping 200. Thank you, Ryan. Oh, here's to you, mate. All right, Ryan, give me a sec here. All right, so we got to go through all these upstairs doors now. And, so Peyron says he was trying to do a Liam Neeson. I watched Taken 2 just the other night again, actually. The only Taken movie I haven't seen yet is number 3. Was it any good? And, I feel you, Conrad. What we got? Let's have a look here. All right, this one's going out to Ryan. I love this one. No. Thank you so much, Ryan. How cool was Vegas Vacation back in the day? And you've never seen Taken. Taken's great. So I think we need to quickly get... that's right, we need to go get the vial of medicine for... What's his name? Richard. And Lamont, good to see Lamont dropping 200 stars. Thank you so much, Lamont. Good to see you today. What's up? I tell you what's not up. It's my voice at the moment. It's still gone. Lamont, this is for you. Thank you, my friend. How you going, John? Good to see you. Joanne says, you're not afraid to admit you're addicted to OneCoin you watch every day. There you go, guys. You heard it here first. OneCoin only is just like, I don't know. What can we compare OneCoin to? I might. It's not up to me to say. I might leave that to you guys. Thank you, Joanne. That's a nice compliment.
Richard, what happened?
So, Philip says you took a vacation to Vegas, stayed for 3 years, and ended up with a kid. That's quite the story, my friend.
There are terrible demons. Ouch!
You're wounded.
Don't forget, two herbs almost completely healed Jill, because she doesn't have as much health as what Chris does.
Poisonous?
So Richard, two greens aren't the end of the world with Jill.
There is serum. Oh no, I should have brought some with me.
No problem.
And,
I'll go and get it.
So we need rehab. We're addicted to OneCoin. Yeah, we all need help. Hey, go on, Eric. Good to see you. Big shout out to Eric from Mexico. He's from Mexico, Chicago. There's a town called Mexico in Chicago, isn't there? Probably. Oh, did we just get raided by Black Lion Gamers? Thank you so much, Travis. Big shout out to our man, Travis. Thank you for coming in, guys. Thanks for hanging out, everybody. We're just doing some Resident Evil today. Guys, absolutely awesome page. Don't forget to check out our friends over at Black Lion Gamers. They kind of do similar stuff to us. Lots of different games. Like, one day they might be doing Mortal Kombat. One day they might be doing Overwatch. And definitely check him out. Travis is, you know, a beacon of positivity in the community, guys. And a big thank you for coming in, guys. Appreciate you, Raiders. Thank you, Luther. No worries, man. We'll see you next time. We've just got to quickly go and get this antidote for Sunbish. And I appreciate you all very much. I love it. Man, look at that. Doesn't OneCoin and D-Wayne look sharp as a sticker? Seriously. We look incredibly sharp. Oh, there we go. So we should be able to get this medicine and go straight back. And so Garrett says we need a combo sticker. We do need a combo sticker. A combo chameleon sticker. Comma. Okay, never mind. Alright. I'm just going to double check this. Let me just make sure this is the key that I think it is. Is this the shield key? Okay. So we need we've got a shield key. Armor key. Is there a sword key as well? I can't remember. Anyway, I'm just going to quickly... I'm a little bit confused here where I've got to find everything. Let's put this away. And, okay. Oh gosh. I can't remember. There's four keys I have to find, isn't there? Is there four keys I have to find? I'm going to leave that herb there just in case. I'm going to take the shotgun out just in case. Okay. And we're going to take the ink ribbon out just in case. Where's the ink ribbon at? There we go. So we're just going to quickly save our game because we haven't saved in ages. Here we go. If I miss any stars, please let me know, guys. I don't mean to be rude here. And, alright. Oh, thank you. That's all. Yeah, don't forget, if you become a supporter of OneCoin Only, you get the VIP streams Monday to Friday with D-Wayne. You get the stickers like Garrett is using. You go in the cash prize draw at the end of every week. Not every week, every month. Jeez, I don't want everyone to think it's every week. I'm not that rich. Jeez, my bad. And then you've also get the whatever Wednesday request once a week. That's what you get once a week. How you going, Dan? Good to see you. Thank you for coming. All right, we can go straight back the way we came now. Oh, I get it, Nightmare. Thank you, dude. I was getting really confused for a second. Okay, well, we should be able to take on this boss now, so no problem. I think we got this. I hope. How you going, Jermaine? Thank you for coming in. Nate says, is Men at Work the most known Australian music band? All I've got to say, Nate, is a big middle finger at the air at you, you stereotyping mother bish. I bet Nate thinks all the women over here go, here we go, here we go, Nate, here we go, rant time. Nate comes in and he's like, is Men at Work the best Aussie band? And while we're at it, does everyone in Australia drink Fosters? Do you have kangaroos in your backyard? And do dingoes really eat your children? Yeah, Nate, I gotta tell you right now, mate, a dingo just ate my baby. Oh my God, crikey, look over there, it's a crocodile. She came right in my backyard, mate. Oh, look over there, it's Skippy. I ride my kangaroo to work. No, Nate. Nate, Men at Work is not the most popular band in Australia. No. Oh, boy. I'm sorry, Nate. I'm sorry, Nate. I had to, bro. I cop it every day. I cop it every day. Every single day. There's always someone. Oh my gosh. Lamont says Rick needs a Tim Tam. Maybe I do need a Tim Tam, my friend. I do have the Tim Tam screen. I just had to find where it was. Thank you, Lamont. I appreciate you. Oh, you're a good sport, Nate. Thank you, bro. I hope you're having a good day, man. But yes, no. Not all Australians listen to Men at Work, okay? not even the older generation really listens to Men at Work. And so Oliver says you had a kangaroo in your backyard once. Well, I have too. That actually is a true stereotype. If you live outside the city, then kangaroos do jump in your backyard. That's actually true. But the rest, no. All right.
Here's the serum. Richard, hold on. I'll give you a shot now.
Jill, here's
okay,
my
I feel
radio.
Better now. It's amazing how much a ramp just like puts the blood going back through your body, hey? Dead Tree Project says Australia needs some new stereotypes. I think so. What do you think, Oliver?
Be careful.
Yeah, swinging it in the breeze, mate. Swinging it in the breeze. Well, you know, we just went to all that trouble to get the antidote for that sumbitch, and he died anyway. Garrick says, I've ever gotten in a fist fight in a kangaroo. You don't want to ever go into a fist fight with a kangaroo. Because if you went into a fist fight with a kangaroo, I can tell you right now, they would absolutely destroy you. You ain't ever, 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 ever gonna win a fight against a kangaroo. Like, seriously? That would not be one of... Yeah. That would be not one of your life's best decisions. Hey, how you going, Jason? Good to see you. All right, I'm hoping one health will be enough. I get a bit nervous about this because we don't have safe states today. Kangaroos can be deadly, especially when they're big. Kangaroos have killed people before, man. Like, most of the time they're placid, but kangaroos are kind of like cats as well. Like, kangaroos will be like your friend 1 minute and then attack you the next. So you can't trust a kangaroo. Or you can trust a kangaroo about as much as you can trust a pussycat. Oh, crap. All right, we need to use this quickly. Yeah, so you really can't trust a kangaroo, hey, like, for real. Um, Oh, I'm in trouble. Come on, Snake. Oh, we got him. All right, so we got lucky. So Ryan says you can jug a beer in less than 3 seconds. You're fine. No, John says that. Have you ever seen a Taipan? Yeah, I have. I mean, snakes are pretty scary, but you know, I don't let them intimidate me too much. Most of them are not aggressive. I know why you guys are scared of snakes, because in the United States, you've got really aggressive snakes. In Australia, we have the most poisonous snakes in the world. But the vast majority of them, I don't think, they're not offensive animals. They're like defensive animals. So you'd have to be doing what Steve Irwin does in order to get bit by a snake over here, you know what I mean? That's why you probably don't hear about more snake deaths in Australia, because most of the time they're pretty passive. Like, I've got a massive red-bellied black snake in my backyard. He just minds his own business. And, Oliver, thank you so much, Oliver, with 100. We did, sir, we did. Yeah, see, Oliver says as soon as, here we go. Yeah, Oliver says as soon as the kangaroo gets up on that tail and starts throwing them legs, it's game over. Yeah, man. And, oh gosh, man, all these racist Australian stereotypes. Fuck off. Alright. Alright, so where are we gonna go now? Oh, look, Jill's about to pass out. She ain't doing too well. Oh no.
Am I poisoned?
I don't know, Jill, you did get bitten by a snake. That might be a clue. I still don't know to this day who rescued Jill. I still don't know to this day who that was rescuing Jill. Sounds good, Eric. We'll see you next time, man. Thank you for coming in. We got Edma in here. Good to see you, Edma. Andrew's like, crikey. Yeah, we do have pretty crazy spiders here. That's one thing about Australia. It doesn't matter if you live in the city or a country. The spiders are a big, big, big problem over here, no matter where you live. So that's a true stereotype.
Barry? Barry?
You think it was Barry? I just never knew for sure, you know? At least we got a free, Alright, so we're gonna... Alright, I guess we're just gonna use our handgun for a little bit longer. And, alright, so we're just gonna check the last of these rooms. Put that away for now. Alright, so let's have a look around, hey? Jordan thinks it was Chris who saved her. No, Chris is kidnapped, remember? Hey! Bury me with your money. Here you go, that was a little bit of, a reference to, what you call it. Sunset Riders. Hey, how you going there, Como? Good to see you, man. Thank you very much for hanging out. Okay, I kind of wasted my ammo on that. I didn't need to shoot that zombie. Oh, well, it is what it is. Let's just keep going. How you doing today, Commodore? Everything all right? I've got plenty of herbs in the chest, Oliver. They're all waiting for me. I've already stockpiled them. All right, give me a sec. Do we need to unlock this yet? No. I need to bring the gem in here, don't I? Okay, that's alright. I'll come back. I'm not doing too bad, man. I just thought we'd do this off the original hardware and widescreen today. Oh, I'm excited that I can now play my PlayStation games off the original hardware. So, that's what we're doing. Alright. We're gonna go back this way. I need to go the other side of the mansion. Chris says you got some herbs in your pantry. I'm actually gonna. I need to fuck around for a little minute here. We need to. We do need to do a little bit of backtracking, but I'll try and get this done as quick as possible. So Como says it's currently 4 a.m. You're eating ice cream and doing a washing. You know what? I may as well do this while I'm here, hey? Just so we can get this over and done with. You haven't missed too much, Mel. I had a bit of a rant, but that was about it. You remember playing this with cheats on the Game Shark? So what kind of stuff would the Game Shark allow you to do? I think if you could run around with like an instant rocket, like an infinite rocket launcher in this game, that would be pretty epic. That would be fun. Now you want ice cream? I actually had ice cream last night for dessert after the pizza. The Domino's ice cream ain't that great, but I mean, you know, I haven't had ice cream for ages, so I still liked it. Damn, no, I feel you, Dead Tree. Hey, man, you know what? No need to show off, hey? Now Lamont says he wants... It's not that type of herbs, guys. It's not that type of herb. Not everything's about the Jamaican tea, you know? You know, the Sunbish Army's all going like, hold up, wait a minute, we need to put some kush up in it. Well, you guys do some, like, kush in your own time. Don't do it on my time. How you going, Cruz? Good to see you again, man. Thank you for coming in. You Sunbishes can't freaking help yourselves, mate. Hold up, wait a minute, Mel's gonna put some kush up in it. Hold up, wait a minute. Alright, let's go. You just had some Jamocha almond fudge from Bath. Man, I like that flavor, dude. We have that flavor over here as well. That's really, really tasty. Hey, go, Mikey. Good to see you. So Garrett says Bluebell's the best ice cream. He must be from California or Texas. We don't have that over here, unfortunately. Thank you very much, Garrett. I'll need to try this Bluebell one day. You know what? That was probably like a stereotype, like all Australians drink Foster's beer. You're probably right, Alfonso. You're probably right. That was a bit of a... that just turned me into a complete hypocrite, didn't it? I apologize. Look at Rick. Rick just got. You're a hypocrite, Rick. You're a hypocrite. You're telling people not to say this about Australia, but you just said it about Jamaica. Yes, I'm a hypocrite, but do as I say, not as I do. Alright, let's go back in here. I'm not lost, guys. I'm just trying to backtrack the quickest way. How you going, Mark? It's good to see you. Thank you for coming in. You're a hypocrite, Rick. You're a hypocrite. Yeah. You say don't do this, but you do it. You're a hypocrite, Rick. You need beer ice cream. Now, that is a good idea. Or rum ice cream, but like with... Not rum extract, actually like rum. Like they need to do an alcoholic rum and raisin. You know what I mean? That would be nuts. I love cheesecake ice cream, Nick. One of my favorites, dude. And Jeremy says, yeah, hypocrisy gets an unfair rap. I think so. Yeah, I mean, you know, like... EO, it's like, you know, and he, you know, God rest his soul, he hasn't been with us for about 40 years, but obviously when someone says Jamaica, obviously one of the first things people think is reggae and Bob Marley. I think that's where you guys probably cop it. We get Foster's beer and kangaroos, and you guys get reggae and Bob Marley. We're going to go back over here. You want to get some rice pudding? I had some rice pudding, actually, a couple weeks ago. My flatmate's a chef, and he actually made some German rice pudding with cinnamon. It was really good. I really enjoyed it. All right, there we go. So that'll do, guys. So we're going to combine this and start putting some stuff away. So we've got plenty of herbs now for the end game. We're in no dramas here. Good night to you too, Veronica. Girl, thank you so much once again for coming in. Can't wait to see you tomorrow. You have a great sleep. Do we ever jam out the didgeridoo? Now, not all Australians own the didgeridoo. You know, the didgeridoo's like a sacred indigenous like instrument, and you can buy them from special stores and stuff, but they're not as common as what you think. Yeah, he was amazing. Here we go again. That just reminds, every time someone says here we go again, that reminds me of Grand Theft Auto 3. Again, as I said, guys, we haven't done anything interesting in a while, but I'm just preparing for the end game here. We're not going to be too far gone. I think we can actually go outside to the next area soon. I think we just need to get one more crest. I think we are almost ready to go. All right, so let's start putting this. As you can see, we've got plenty of herbs now. And I'm going to leave this one here, and we're going to take the star crest. And what else do we... Is there any other crests in here? No, that's it. No, that's it. No, so we just got one more crest to get, I think. Which I think is up here, if I'm not mistaken, and then we're out of here. Which, yeah, that was a great song. Did I end up getting that crest from the snake room? I don't know if I got the crest from the snake room. I can't... Oh, no. I know what room I haven't done. I haven't done that armor room yet. Okay, I know which crest I'm missing. Okay. There you go. We got most valuable players in here. Good to see you, Chris. Thank you for coming in. Hope you're doing fantastic. Okay, so we're just going to check out a couple things in here. And Ryan says, so I'm going to go to bed. Don't forget to support OneCoin only. And hey, maybe visit a cat named Cracker. I ain't visit no cat called Cracker. Nah, Ryan, dude, thank you so much. Yeah, check him out. And have a great sleep, bro. Once again, thank you so much for the support today.
Wait, hang on. Do you really think you have a chance against us?
Thank you so much, Ryan. Way. We'll see you again tomorrow, brother, hey? Thank you so much, my friend. And you have a non-crest in your... No, I know where I have to go. I've got to quickly get a couple things. I know where to go. Thank you so much for the big 500. You keep cinnamon on your beehives to keep the ants out. Wow, I didn't realize that was a thing. All right, so we just need to press this switch. We are so close to being out of here, guys. Don't you worry about that. Oh, good on you. 4 gigabytes not really going to be a whole lot to play modern games, Peyron, to be honest. Like, if you want to play modern games, you kind of need at least 8 gig of RAM, Peyron. Just to be truthful with you, man. I mean, you could do all the Steam independent games with that much RAM, but you're not going to really have much more options. Some games you can play in low resolution with that. How you going, Daniel? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. You don't think cake and ice cream go together? I had a chocolate lava cake and ice cream last night, and I can tell you right now, Joanne, they go very, very, very well together. And Chris says that Highlander, there can only be one. I need to find where that screen is. It's been a minute since I've done the Highlander screen. Here we go. This is for you. Thank you, Chris. It's Commodore's cousins. There you go. Well, I mean, if trees keep falling on your cousins, Commo, you're not going to have any cousins left. All right, we need to get this... There we go, got another ammo. Yeah, I mean, you really, to future tech your computer, you need at least 16, I would think, yeah. The way games are going, you're going to need 16 now. And, alright, let's go. We just got one more room to go in, and then we can leave this mansion, thankfully. And we can actually do some fun stuff again. Big thank you for waiting, guys. I know backtracking's really annoying. Como says those cousins gave you crap Christmas presents anyway. Guys, if you haven't yet, please don't forget to like the stream if you can, guys. It really, really helps us out. There we go. So we should be done with this key now. It should give us more space. This key is useless now. There we go. We've literally gone in every room in this mansion now. So now after we get this next crest, we go outside, we done. We're all good. I think it's only 3 crests, or is it 4? No, we only need 3 crests, don't we? Is it 3 or 4? Can you guys remember? It's only 3, right? But we gotta be careful that we don't press that button by accident. And Timmy says he's back to work. Timmy, I hope you had a good week off, my friend. Timmy, as soon as you find that hiding spot, my brother, you check back in with us. And Timmy, this one's going out to you today. Thank you, thank you, thank you, brother. And thank you, Edma, as well. Timmy, thank you again. Edma, this is for you. Oh, the moon chest crest was in the chest. Are you sure? How many crests is it? Is it? There's 4 crests. So the other one was in the chest. Was it really? Did I forget to pick up the one with the snake? We can go back up and have a look anyway. I didn't see it in the chest. Are you sure it was there? Are you 100% sure it was there? Because I didn't see it. I thought I looked. Anyway, it doesn't... Okay, you know what? We'll just go back and have a look. Alright, so the moon crest is in the chest. Let's go back and have a look. Yep, okay. I don't know how I didn't see it. Alright, that's alright. We're right around the corner from that where we need to go anyway. Okay, so it is in the chest. Okay, well the chest is just around the corner and so is the exit anyway, so... Oh my gosh, really? Went the wrong way. Fuck you, you stupid bish. Or excuse me. Rick's getting a bit angry now. That's alright. And so Seth says 100%, alright. I'm just not very good with my peripheral vision, what can I tell ya? Yeah, who'd be messaging me at this time? Why are you messaging me? You know I stream. Stop messaging me while I stream, fuckers. There we go, that's a bit rude, isn't it? Hey, go on, Raphael. I'm doing good, man. We're just about to go to the next part of the game. We're almost done here. Just gonna go get this crest and we out of here. We're gonna get some health too. Actually, no, we will not need the health because we can get that in the next area. I'm gonna take a chance. I'm not gonna save until we get to the outhouse. Gonna save these ink ribbons. So we're gonna put that away. So there is a moon crest in here. Alright, well that works. We're gonna shoot some dogs outside. Well, let's go, guys. We got this. We're out of here. Hey, how you going, Josh? Are you having a good day? We got Gary in here too. Thank you for hanging out, fellas. Let us know what you're getting up to. What I really hated about the remake of this game is the doorknob could fall off this door. I don't know, did any of you guys like the Resident Evil 1 remake? I couldn't get into it, hey. Right, out we go. Now we got to be careful because there's a dog just around this corner too. Mark says, Rick, please do the hot dog dance. Mark, I am not here for your entertainment. I mean, not that type of entertainment anyway. Come on. You sure if you rapid fire the button near the dogs, they don't detect you? Really? I don't really take that chance today. All right, take that, you son of a bitch. Don't tell Peter on me. All right, so we should just be able to use all these. You like when dogs are friends? I mean, I love dogs. I'm kind of torn because I'd love to have a dog more than anything in the world, but I also like apartment living. So Jordan says you love the remake. I hated the inventory management on that. That was really, really bad. And Andrew says I'm a monster. Hey, bro, if the shoe fits, huh? If the shoe fits. Yeah, Daniel, you gotta love their algorithm. It's certainly not perfect, my friend, so hang in there. Alright, so we're just gonna go get this crank. And this puzzle's basic by today's standards, isn't it? If you shoot a dog and then run at him, you can kill him with a knife. I think you overestimate the amount of skill that I have, personally. I think you guys think I have more skills than what I actually do. Victor just dropped a big 25 stars. Thank you, Victor. Victor, this one's for you today. Thank you, Victor. Really appreciate the support, my homie. A little bit of Lionel Richie always suffices. And thank you, man. All right, here we go. We're going to go out here. There we go, we're gonna combine those herbs. We'll wait till after we've taken on these dogs. Oh gosh. I better grab a herb now. Yeah. Will you take the herb? Yes. And I'm gonna use the aforementioned herb right now. Because I don't trust myself. Oh, come on! Are you kidding me? Oh, dude. No, Jill. Oh, you fuck off. Dude, I haven't saved in so long. Oh, weak. That's rooted. Oh, that is so rooted. I'm not going back and doing all that shit again, guys. I fucked it up. Oh, my God. This was a really, really bad idea today. This was a really, really bad idea. Alright, I tell you what I'm going to do, guys. I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put on a bonus game, and then I'm going to come on with a late night stream, because I fucked it. I can't believe it. I didn't use an ink ribbon for ages. It'd take me like an hour to get back there. Oh my gosh. That really, really sucks. Oh, it happens. That hurts. Yeah, it's all right. I'll put on a bonus game for you guys. Sorry about that, everyone. Jesus. I've played that game with, like, save states for so long. I overestimated my skills, I think, hey? And so use shotguns and the dogs, why didn't you save that? Duh. Yeah, thank you, Patrick. Hindsight's a wonderful thing, isn't it? You didn't tell me that before. And, alright, here's our bonus game. We're going to be playing Die Hard 2 on Die Hard Trilogy Disc. So, Raph, thank you for being a good sport. Raph just dropped 100 stars. This is how I feel right now. Thank you, Raph. I better put my headband back on. Alright. Alright. No, we're going to do a bonus game. I'm going to make up for it on the late night, guys. I completely screwed that. I was not expecting that to happen. I know I won't destroy it. Alright, here we go. Headband. And, Die Hard Vendetta. This is a bit different. This will be our bonus game, because we haven't been on for long. And let me just tag the different game here. Let me see if I can tag a different game. Die Hard. Die Hard Trilogy, here we go. Updating the tag there. It's a bonus game. So, Player 40 says some more Stairman stars. Thank you so much, Player 40. Josh just dropped a big 300 stars. Thank you, Joshy. This is for you once again. As I said, I hope Facebook don't flag me. And I knew you'd like that one. I was kind of thinking of you too, Josh, when I did that one. Thank you, brother. I did die, Jeremy. Yeah, I screwed up. I'll try again one day, guys. I'll try again. And yes, it was one of the first games I had on... I used to rent this, and this ended up being one of the first games I had... We gotta quit. So yeah, this was one of the first games I had on Sony PlayStation. Alright, I'm going to Die Hard 2, not Die Hard 1 today. Yeah, I'll try again eventually, just not today. I mean, I think I'm going to be burnt out from Resident Evil 1 now for a very, very long time. I'm so done with it. But yeah, we'll do it. As I said, this is what we're doing right now as our bonus game. Alright, here we go. Almost done. Thank you so much for hanging around regardless, guys. I know you had your heart set on a full playthrough. That's alright. We are going to come back on. Yeah, too soon. I used to love this game back in the... I feel like this game turned out a lot better than Resi did as far as graphics went. So it's kind of a rail shooter. You're just going to shoot a bunch of enemies in this. Funny thing was, this was nearly planned as well as what we... Yeah. I nearly actually planned this game today. I should have just put it in the description. I love that you can shoot the innocents in this too. You don't really get much of a penalty apart from points. Take that, you sumbitches. Oh gosh. I keep pressing the wrong button to reload. You're gonna shoot the coke machines in this. You shoot the coke machines. Yeah, you shoot the coke machines, you get health out of them. But it's really, really hard because you get distracted so much. Damn. There we go. I love how violent this game is. It's neat. I'm gonna have to pause and catch comments from time to time. And, also, Joanne says, you never got to play this, so you're glad I picked this one. So, there's like three games in the Die Hard trilogy. And, you've got like, the first Die Hard, which is a third-person shooter where you run around and you've got to go through the Nakatomi Plaza. And then you've got the second one, which is this, a rail shooter. And you've got the third one, which is like a beat-the-clock kind of like racing game. Which is really, really fun, but hard to play. It takes a while to get used to it. So as I said, I'm just going to pause every now and then to catch comments, because this game is balls to the wall. Oh my gosh. So this follows every single movie level from the movie too, which is really neat. Like, as far as movie-based games goes, this is definitely one of the better ones. And it's weird seeing how the innocent people run, I know. You think this reminds you of Time Crisis? Unfortunately, they never ever made this game compatible with the gun, but this kind of gives me more of the Virtua Cop vibes. I feel like it gives me more of the Virtual Cop vibes. Alright. Oh, we got him. Oh, we got an explosive shotgun. That's just going to tear their house down. I love it. And part two of the movie was so gnarly. Number one and two were great. Number three was okay. And then afterwards, I don't count it. And, yeah, Patrick on YouTube just says this would have been really dope if they used a light gun. Yeah, this was a couple years before the PlayStation light gun came out. They brought this game out just a little bit early, didn't they? We're almost out of this level. Levels are usually only a couple minutes long each.
Hey, I must have been a good boy.
There we go, we'll stockpile our weaponry a bit longer. You got grenades and rockets you can use as well. Very generous amount, come to think of it. I know, I mean, I think for a game from 1996, this still holds up incredibly. I love it. This is one of those few games that I do play in my own time. Okay. You see all the Christmas, you know, the attention to detail. You can see all the holly and Christmas decorations set up as well. Because, I mean, let's not forget, Die Hard is a Christmas movie, boys and girls. Die Hard is 100% a Christmas movie.
Sorry, pal.
Sorry, pal. Yippee-ki-yay. He does say yippee-ki-yay in this, and he just doesn't say the motherfucker bit. Alright. Alright, we got you, you sumbish.
Sorry, pal.
Alright. I'm gonna pause here. So this is a Christmas movie, Peyron, don't you? It is so. Die Hard is a Christmas movie. Who, if you don't think Die Hard's a Christmas movie, well then you can just skedaddle from one coin because that's the biggest offense ever. That's a bit rude, isn't it, Rick? Wow, Rick. Rick's like, well, if you don't agree with me, you can all quit one coin. No, I don't roll like that. I was only messing. Please don't leave. Don't leave me. Don't leave me like everyone else in my life has left me. Oh, wow. This is going to get away a little bit too deep. Do you think they need to do another Max Payne game? I really like the third one. Max Payne's dope. If they brought out a new Max Payne game, I would never say no. Well, there we go, we've got ourselves a gnarly shotgun now, sweet. Man, this has got some, aww. Oh gosh. Bruh, we need to start throwing grenades here and shit. Oh gosh, come on. I love how much damage you can do the backgrounds in these levels too, like that really adds to the, like it feels very immersive for an old game. We absolutely destroyed this freaking airport. we just absolutely totaled it. Oh my gosh, have I ever played Tenchu? I grew up with the second Tenchu game. I find them very, very hard to play now, Jordan, because of the wonky camera angles and stuff, you know. Die Hard's a, if there's Christmas decorations and Christmas songs, it's a Christmas movie. If there's Christmas decorations and Christmas songs, it's a Christmas movie. And when Bruce Willis said Die Hard's not a Christmas movie, he was joking. He was joking. He was trolling his fans. And Jeremy must be Santa. That Mark's going, no worries, Mark. We'll see you next time, brother. Thank you for coming in. This game takes a lot of focus, doesn't it? Tenchu was alright. I don't think Tenchu holds up that great now, to be honest. But you've got so many other games like Tenchu now anyway, like Ghost of Tsushima and stuff. You've got all these modern day Tenchu games now. I think Tenchu's now obsolete. Just didn't like the look on his face. Oh gosh. Lucky we got this machine gun on, Well, we got you. So I've beaten this game many times, but it takes a bit of practice. Well, there is a dude over there still. Oni, you really liked Onimusha as well. I've got Onimusha on the to-do list. I've never played it, but I own it on PS4. So that Onimusha's on my homework list. Is there a lot of backtracking in Onimusha like Resident Evil, or do you think Onimusha's a little bit more linear? What do you guys think? Hey going, Chris, good to see you. Oh gosh, we got the Tracer too. Oh boy. oh, we just shot an innocent, but who cares? You know what they said in Wrath of Khan, the need of the many outweighs the needs of the few. So, yeah. Breaking all sorts of laws today. How you going, JR? Thank you so much for coming in. I appreciate you, man. We're just doing our bonus game because I totally fucked up Resident Evil today. And now I don't want to play Resident Evil 1 again for a very, very, very long time. Like, for a very long time. Hey, we just got raided by our friend Grunge X. Thank you, Mikey. Don't forget to check out our good friends over at Grunge X, guys, as well as the Global Stream Machine. Good to see you, brother. Thank you for coming in. You would skip Onimusha and dive into the second one, really? Well, I've got whatever one I bought on PS4. And Matt says you missed the mess up. Dang, yes, I know you like to watch people fuck up, Matt. I don't know, because... Jeez, Matt, you're a peculiar one, sir. Matt's like, oh, I missed the negative thing. I missed the negative thing. Oh, I have to be up one coin only when something negative happens. I'm going to pause here quickly. Oh, so Mike says he still owns this on a physical disc as well. Good to see you, James. James, I'm doing pretty good, man. I just have to quickly plan a late night stream now, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I have no idea what I'm doing for late night stream. So I'll figure something out. Alright. I'm breaking so many laws today, it's not even funny, hey? Oh gosh, I've only got like 2 health points. Oh, I'm in big trouble, guys. I'm in really, really big trouble here. Big trouble. I think towards the end of the level we can get a lot more health, but... Oh gosh, dude! Oh no, I've got no health left. Oh bruh, I'm so gone. Where's the health at? Oh my gosh. Where's the health at? Dude. Oh gosh. I know I got a star donation. Forgive me, guys. I'm just... I think this is the end of the level now. Jesus. Alright. Marco's in here. Marco just dropped a big 100 stars. Thank you, Marco. This is for you. How you going, Johnny? Good to see you. And so, John says you don't care if it's a win or lose. You're still loving the stream 3 years. Man, that is one of the nicest things you could say to me, dude. I really appreciate that. Man, it didn't go to as planned, but, you know, we had a backup request here. So, you know, no harm, no foul. And Marco, thank you so much for the 100 again. Thank you so much for the kind words, Johnny. Don't forget to check out Captain Cornflakes. And, oh my gosh. Yeah, man, this is just a freaking... Okay, I need some water, guys. I need to get my breath back. James wants me to play some Sonic Force again. Dude, I probably will eventually. I might, you know, I do want to play Sonic tonight. I might do some different Sonic games. Might not be a bad idea. All right. Deep breath. I'm going to try and hold on to my life as long as I can. Now, we just got past the hardest bit of this level, which is the good news. This is, like, the end here. And you can see, we got some health back. Alright, so we're almost out. Jeez, man. It's crazy. Oh, boy. Oh, my gosh. Dude! Oh my gosh. Alright. Mikey, there you go. We got Grunge X with a big 200 stars. Thank you so much, Grunge X. I can't thank you enough for the star donation, man. What are we going to give to Grunge X? Alright, Rick, stay calm. I think this star screen is appropriate. This is for you, Grunge X. Thank you, my man. I appreciate you, Mikey. Alright. So, I guess we'll do, you're here to watch the sunbish with a controller. Yeah, that didn't work out. Let's try one more Die Hard game. I'll do a quick run of Die Hard 3, where you have to knock over all the bombs. This is really hard. You're going to see how freaking hard this is in a sec. And then I'm going to put myself out of my misery and set up a late night stream. Oh my gosh. Oh, this fucking stream is a train wreck. Nah. Since when did Rick become a goat? Oh boy. Alright. Train wreck, mate. Train wreck. I'm like Miley Cyrus's wrecking ball, but in real life. So I gotta remember how to do these tight turns, so give me a second here. Trying to remember which way to... There's a handbrake button here, but I can't remember what it is. Oh, that's a handbrake button. Hang on. Where's the handbrake button? I'm just trying to figure out the buttons. Oh my gosh. Trying to figure out the handbrake button. There you go, there's the handbrake button. Alright, cool. So we get what you the goal in this is to whack the bombs. You gotta get the bombs before they blow up. Alright, so now where are we going? Shit! Man, the controls in this are whack. Oh my gosh! Damn it, man. Who remembers playing this? It takes so much to get used to. I love it how you run over people, their blood just goes all over the windshield. Alright, here we go. Alright, time extension, fantastic. Oh my gosh, get out of the way, you sumbish. Oh boy. Oh no. Cut left up here, alright, I will. Ah, damn it. How you going, Seeker? Good to see you. Thank you for hanging out. Alright, we're gonna try one more time. Seriously, after this game, I'm pressing the reset button. Alright. There we go, we're gonna use this turbo. Oh boy, so we're gonna smash all the bombs, that's the goal. Man, I don't know how I played this game as a kid. I was a lot better when I was younger. I like the music in this one too, it has to be said. Oh, so the bomb's not in... Oh, shit. So where's the bomb then? We are gonna die, Samuel. Oh my god. How you going, Bian? Good to see you. Alright, last chance. Different plan of attack. Let's go, let's get that other bomb. Come on, we can do this. Let's use another one. Oh gosh. Go on, Rick. Get up. There's too many cars in the way. Oh my gosh. Alright, so we're going to go down this way. Farkity. And then we're going to go in here, I guess. And where's this bomb at? Shit, we don't have much time. The bombers are coming. We need to smack this bomb. No! Oh my gosh, this is like the first level and it's hard as freaking balls. Oh my gosh. Alright. Alright guys, I'm gonna... Seriously, I'm putting myself out of my misery now and I'm coming on with a late night stream because this had not turned out as planned. Thank you so much for watching. You guys are absolutely amazing. Enjoy yourselves the next 40 minutes. And I'll be right back on and we're going to have a hell of a time. But right now I'm going to take this Resident Evil or Die Hard case, whatever, and start bashing it over my fucking head. All right. Love you guys. You are awesome. Back shortly. Hooroo. Oh my goodness.
Right, buckle up. Come left up here. Right, buckle up.